She dug out the residue yogurt with her hands and asked the girl to finish it. You might be thinking she tried to teach children not to waste food, but the yogurt was already expired. After the master left for work, she would sleep on their bed and look at the lady master's panty containing period stains unhappily. Paul and Miriam hired Louis, an experienced nanny, a few months ago to look after their two kids. Since then, Louis had kept the house tidy and clean. The clothes were sorted and placed neatly. Louis stayed in a slum area in a poor environment. She would leave home very early to work, though the master did not have such expectations. Early morning, when Miriam woke up, she saw Louis already reached her house. As Louis took care of the two children, Paul and Miriam were able to work and have their private time. They appreciated Louis and treated her like a family member. They brought her for a family outing. Louis was afraid of water. Paul personally taught her to learn to swim at the beach. But very soon, the nanny revealed the evil nature. When she played games with the children, she deliberately hid, making the girl look around for a long time. When the baby boy was crying, she would ignore him. She did this to make the children in need of her and so that she can control them. On the next day, she held a party for the daughter and she invited her friends. She played with the children who came to the house as if she were the house owner. Miriam, who was busy, was not aware of the party and she was too tired to ask Louis. The neighbor's babysitter in the park showed off to Louis that her master was very kind. She also warned Louis she might be out of the job soon when the baby boy started walking and attending nursery. Louis felt insecure. She searched for various pregnancy recipes and started to include them in the meals for Miriam. Louis would induce the daughter. She said that they could move to a bigger house if they have another baby. One day, she took the initiative to bring the two children out for dinner. She would stay in the restaurant for a long time, as she wanted Paul and Miriam to spend time alone to have another baby. But when Louis reached the house with the two children, Paul was playing mobile on the sofa while Miriam had already fallen asleep. On the next day, she was angry to see period stains on a panty in the master room. Her plan did not succeed. One day, the children's grandma came. Louis looked upset as her position as caretaker for the house might be threatened. At a glance, the grandmother noticed something weirdness about Louis. She advised her daughter-in-law to spend more time at home with the children. Miriam felt Louis sometimes decided something without consulting her, but there was no reason to let her go for her overall good performance. The family went to their grandma's house for a few days' vacations. Louis came to the house, acting as if she was the owner of the house. She used the master room's bathtub, enjoying the luxury around, and made a mess in the place. But before the owner returned, she had cleaned out the house. Miriam was very grateful to the nanny, who even came during the rest time. Louis' rude behavior was getting severe. One day she asked the daughter for her potty. She passed her urine on it and asked the daughter to pour her urine. The baby boy was crying loudly, but Louis ignored him. She would always stand alone at the window in a daze. Miriam called her several times. Paul received a letter from the tax department asking them to deduct the debt owed by Louis from her salary. Paul felt embarrassed for this letter and reprimanded Louis. Louis cried. She explained that her husband left the debts before their divorce. She had a daughter, but she was not given custody rights due to the obligation for the debts. Miriam is a lawyer. She offered help to solve these problems if Louis could provide relevant documents. Louis returned home with grief. She saw a pile of government letters reminding payments, making her frustrated. She thought she could live a better life by being a nanny in an upper-class family, but now she might lose her job. Louis yelled and vented his dissatisfaction with life. The couple quarreled because of Louis. Paul was determined to fire Louis, but Miriam disagreed as she needed a nanny to take care of the children and the housework when she was working. Miriam stayed at home to take care of the children for a day since Louis did not come. The baby boy was crying the whole day, making Miriam frustrated. The couple decided to let Louise continue the work. Louise returned the following days. She found a flyer on the floor. The couple had started to look for a nursery for the baby boy. Once they found a suitable nursery, she would be out of the job. Since then, she began to sabotage. She did not greet Miriam in the morning. In the evening, she left a boneless chicken on the table. Miriam was scared, as it appeared like a warning to her. Miriam called her husband as she was frightened. They decided to fire Louise after this weekend. But tragedies always come so quickly. Louise used a sharp knife to kill the two children. When Miriam returned, Louise already committed suicide, and the two children were dead, leaving only bloodstains in the house. Miriam screamed. The police arrived here and took away Louise's body. Paul, who had just returned downstairs, did not know that he had lost two children. The movie did not highlight Louise's motive, but there is a big difference between Louise and Paul's family from the details. Paul and Miriam are highly educated, live in a high-end area, but Louise lived in slum with a failed marriage. When she worked for the family, she began to enjoy luxury life, and she would be reluctant to go back to her old life. Why would she hope that the couple to have more children? She felt that through this, she could show her value to continue her employment to enjoy such a lifestyle. The nanny with such a nice appearance killed the two children. Domestic helpers come from different backgrounds, and you may not know what they are thinking. As a gentle reminder, parents shall not be negligent. We need to participate and monitor the domestic helpers' involvement in taking care of children. That's all for today. If you like my video, please subscribe. Until next time, bye!